When I was younger, I was great at printing, like an architect. Over time, it was becoming harder and harder. Then it got to the computer mouse, and typing. I used to type about 180 words a minute, and it just got worse and worse. And I was always very organized, and I was very thorough and detailed, and it changed. Who I was as a person was changing, and I knew that there was something wrong.
Parkinson's disease is a clinical diagnosis, so there's really no absolute test that absolutely defines it. It's not like diabetes where we have a blood test, or like a stroke where we can just take a picture of the brain. It's really a clinical diagnosis, which means that we listen to the signs and symptoms that are described by the patient. We also do a physical exam. The classic symptoms that we teach our medical students about, they actually spell the word TRAP, T-R-A-P. T stands for tremor, so the tremor is usually a one-sided tremor in one hand or one leg, and it's usually at rest. R stands for rigidity, which means that patients have increased tone that we can measure on the exam. A stands for akinesia, or lack of movement, and patients will complain of slowness, that they've slowed down. And then P stands for postural instability, and that can be a later finding, usually in classic Parkinson's disease, where patients will have falls, they'll have balance issues, and they'll start to sort of lose their balance while they're walking.
Well, first it happens once in a while. With the hand motion and the shaking, that became a standard. But the writing, the organization, and the little confusion, and getting fuzzy about things, it was intermittent. I figured everybody has that.
We're really trying to start off on the right foot, so it's really important to emphasize things like sleep. So getting a good night's sleep every night, we try to emphasize about 8 hours at the very least, if possible. Not napping in the day. Additionally, we think that exercise is very key. We're not talking about an overnight change from being sedentary to running a marathon, but setting goals and trying to keep within those goals is very important. And then eating well, keeping otherwise healthy. We really emphasize the fact that patients live near normal lifespans with this disease, so we want to keep all the other body systems working, keep our stroke risk down, cardiac risk factors down, so eating right and being healthy. It's absolutely important to get educated. That's our goal, is to get patients, you know, reading about the disease, getting linked up with some of these organizations that have a lot of good material to read.
Now I'm doing all the research that I can. I'm going to a support group. I want to talk to some human beings that know and are living it.
I think that having a good relationship with your physician is very important as well, and being able to open up and be honest. I find some patients really minimize their symptoms and try to tell their doctor that they're able to do everything and that they're really fine when they really aren't.
Get a doctor that you really trust and talk to them. Talk to them about your anxieties. Get the people around you that you love to work with you so none of you will panic. Inform your family. Let them know that it can be A to Z and it doesn't have to be so bad, you know, with a little support from your family, you know. So they'll do some of the cutting in the kitchen, and you'll save your fingers.
We would encourage vets who are newly diagnosed with Parkinson's to seek out the subspecialty care that is available at the VA, because it is a really nice group of doctors across the country, and we're constantly involved in research and education, and really feel that our expertise should be shared throughout the VA population, and we're happy to share that with our vets.
One thing I've learned through my past relationships is that I always try to take care of my mate. What I've learned now that I have Parkinson's is that I have to make myself the priority. If I don't take care of myself, I can't really take care of someone else.
To many patients, it is a disease that comes with a stigma, and it can be quite a life-changing diagnosis. So the main thing that we want to convey to our patients is that it's a very treatable diagnosis. It's really about instilling a positive attitude from the get-go. And these lifestyle changes are key. Probably better than any medicine out there is a set good exercise regimen and, you know, good sleep, good diet, and keeping a very positive attitude. So especially at these early stages, we really emphasize positive attitude, education, and exercise are super key.
I'm gonna live every day to the fullest. I don't know when it's gonna end. I'm gonna enjoy my life. I am gonna go camping. I'm gonna travel. I'm gonna do whatever makes me happy. I'm just gonna make the best out of every day. That's the most important thing to me.